Ready to go then here. Round of 16 action in the men's singles here in Budapest at these Lipa ITTF 2019 World Table Tennis Championships. Fan Zhendong, the world number one, to begin here to his fellow Chinese Liang Jinkun. Guy McCree taking you through this one. Best of seven games, as always, for a quarterfinal spot here in Budapest. First to 11 points in each of these sets. Yeah, very good form that Liang's built up to get into the world's top 10. Looking at his results, fell in the round of 16 here, actually, in the end of January. Of course, the first top-level event on the ITTF World Tour of 2019, the Hungarian Open. And then fell at that same stage at the Qatar Open last month, Liang. So not spectacular results, but solid. But he certainly was pretty spectacular how he went about the second half of 2018. Runner-up at the Korean Open, then won, of course, in Linz, won the Austrian Open, quarterfinals at the Swedish Open as well. Quarterfinals at the China Open earlier on in last season as well. So he's built up results, and that's why he's in the world's top 10 now. Very consistent performance, highlighted by that title in Austria. Fan, of course, the most consistent out there. You don't get to the top of the ITTF world rankings without doing that, and he's been there now for a year in that position at the summit. First half of this opening game. Fan, of course, with another service to come here. Try and stretch the advantage to two here over Liang. Just went for a little flick there. Didn't have a lot of table to work with there, Liang. It's a pretty tough shot. Going into a pretty small area of the table. Try and find that, find the edge, the line. Now that's where Fan, of course, is so strong. We've seen so much of that when he pivots into his backhand corner. Loads through the legs, through the lower body. He's so strong. Lead up to three now. And again, that's what he does so well. The first really meaty rally here. And Fan winning the topspin exchange, as he generally always does. Backhand topspin rallies. This man is so difficult to stop. Slightly away from the table. And you can see Liang there, try as he might, just not able to get on top of the world number one. Oh, this is impressive, isn't it? Mention how the first half of the game was tight. Led 5-4, but the last 4 points going Fan's way. Now two from this opening game.
Four, 10.
Four. change
Five,
the direction there from Liang to save the first of these six game points here. Yeah, 11, second one though, taken by Fan Zhendong, the world number one, off to an excellent start here. Good surge in the second half of that opening game to take it 11-5.
Second game, Liang to serve, love-all.
Liang to begin this second game, falling victim to a terrific surge from Fan Zhendong to win that game from 5-4, reeling off in the end six of the last 7 points of the game.
One
imperative here for Liang that he gets a good start in this second game. If he falls a couple of games down, well, Fan is such a good front runner. In addition to all his other qualities, I feel that Liang here has got to try and win this second game if he can.
Love two.
He's got the first couple of points.
One, two.
Very good. He was able to get the first strike in there, Liang. That was the problem in the opening game. Fan was doing a good job of neutralising him. Misses there. Need to flick that away. Little slip there from Fan with the push. Not getting the amount of backspin that he wanted there. Drifting long. He's done well there because he's managed to redirect into the Fan forehand. Got it out of the backhand topspin trade there, Liang. That's imperative for his chances. Mentioned in the first game how strong Fan is. Backhand cross table. But Liang there was able to change the direction and drew the error. Oh, it's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant from Liang. What a good fight back this is. Fan looking to open up and go to Liang's forehand, but he might regret doing it there. That was just too good. Heavy topspin. And much like Fan produced a mid-game surge to move away with the first game, Liang looks to be doing something similar here. The lead up to four. Big serves here for Fan to come. He needs both of them. No. This is his forehand. Liang now becoming a big favourite to level up here. Did think that this man would test the world number one with the form that he's got, the way he's come up the rankings. Imagine how tough a draw this is for Fan at this stage at the round of 16. Not just to play a fellow Chinese, but also to play someone who's in the top 10 in the world at this stage. It's a rough draw. Six game points then for Liang here to level up. Oh, he's done him. What a performance there from Liang Jingkun to take the second game off the world number one. 11-4. One game all here. Game on.
Third game, Fan to serve, Lavo.
Third game here, just in its second point. And the run here being put together by Liang Jingkun is becoming even more and more impressive. First two games, similar really. Fan taking the first set out of neutral to run those points together, and Liang doing something similar. Although, to be honest, he led from the off in the second game. He just kept Fan at arm's length and then powered away. Oh, there's the change. That's the class of Fan Zhendong. Needed that. Having lost the first 2 points of this third game. Able to get it onto his forehand and change direction, because actually he's needing to do that. Liang is holding up much better than maybe would have expected in those backhand topspin trades cross table, where Fan is so strong. And then we've got the flick backhand from Liang, first to it, taking time away from Fan. Three of the first 4 points, the world number one coming under a bit of pressure now. This is what we thought, Liang would test him. This is exactly what's happening at the moment. Does Fan just seem a little bit rattled here? Looked like when he put those runner points together to take the first game, he was just setting his stall out again, managing the match. How good has this been from Liang Jingkun here for the last 10 minutes really now?
4-2.
Look away and just a disappointment, but Liang is still in a great place. He doesn't need to get down on himself here. Lead of two. Oh, well, I've got to say, I was feeling a bit for Liang there, because he just couldn't convert that rally. And Fan is here. Look how low he gets. And his knees are on the floor. The amount of power. Initially, before he comes out of that squat position. Fan edging his way back here. Big service for Liang that he'll look to hold on to stay in front, having led through the first part of this third game. No, this is what the world number one's all about. He's digging his way back, having been made to feel pretty uncomfortable, I think. Just whipping around the outside of the ball there. And some side spin as well as the top spin Fan. Get that ball moving away from Liang's forehand. Really good tussle this at the moment.
Six.
The lead at two again. Serves to come as well for Liang. How mentally strong is Fan here? It's always likely to be the toughest test by far that he's going to get in the event so far. Hadn't lost a set coming in. Oh, and that was, well, it was a nothing shot really by his high standards. Went for the loop return there, Fan. That really didn't, wasn't clear the table. Feeling the pressure. Oh, it's a shame for Liang. Some amazing defense. Coming back again. What a huge serve this is for Fan. Oh, it's brilliant for Liang as well. He's won the backhand topspin trade. Where Fan there, having got the service behind it, got to his favoured position. To lose this is a hammer blow. His forte. And Liang taking it. Two game points here to move ahead of the world number one. Oh, he's taken him as well. That's stunning. Absolutely stunning from Liang Jingkun. 11 points to 8, and he's now 2 games to 1 up here on the world number one. Well, long way to go here still in this men's singles round of 16, but Fan Zhendong, the world number one, 2 games to 1 down.
One love.
I've got to say at this point, personally, I'm not totally surprised. Having discussions here with prominent table tennis reporters, journalists this morning before this match, suggesting that Fan would come through this, not necessarily 4-0 again. Yeah, he may well turn this round, but I was personally the opinion, having seen Liang quite a bit, for instance, at the event, the Challenge Plus event in Lisbon in February, which he won. Of course, that's not a top level, but it had a very good field there. Just his form in general, his confidence, I felt he could really push Fan here. And that's exactly what's happening at the moment. One thing to push, though, and it's another thing to go on, of course, and it would be complete a stunning victory. He's nine in the world, but to beat the world number one here would go down as a, still would go down as a huge upset. He's halfway towards doing that at the moment. Four games the target, of course. Still plenty of time, though, in this format, in this dynamic, for Fan to come back into this. A little bit fortunate there, as he acknowledged the way he won that point. Splitting the first 6 points here. Well, we talk about a lot, don't we, about getting inside the minds of the ITTF campaign at the moment, inside my mind, getting inside a player, how they go about their business at the table. Fascinating to get inside Fan Zhendong's mind right now. Getting inside the mind of both of these two. Such a big occasion. How Liang is feeling right now, what he's thinking.
Four all.
Fan, yeah, just a little bit of emotion. Don't see a lot of that from him. A little bit of chatter to himself. Normally so stoic in his outlook. Oh, and the vocalisation from Liang there, very good. Punctuation point. He has the lead again. This is just, this is pivotal really in this match. These next few minutes, difference between 3-1 and 2-all in games. Fan redirects. Extending through up the table here beautifully, the world number one. Look at this. Really, no time at all there for Liang to get across to his forehand side.
Six, seven. 7 all.
Now Liang is hanging with the world number one here. You can't get away from it. This match is going to be a long way, I think, to being potentially decided here in these next couple of minutes. Fan, of course, has got the ability to come from 3-1 down, but he's not going to want to be in that hole. Not against a player of Liang's caliber, the way he's playing. Oh, and he's given him the runaround there. Pushed Fan well away from the table. Was there just a bit of lack of conviction there in Fan's defensive set? Pushed out of position and a bit half-hearted how he went to cover the backhand. Can Liang keep this together? Wow, are we on the way to something here? Of course, we had Simon Gauzy shocking Xu Xin on Wednesday here at these ITTF World Table Tennis Championships here in Budapest. And, well, I mean, it's 9 in the world here. Liang is not exactly a low-level player, but still up against the world number one. Few expected. Fan Zhendong to be in this sort of trouble, but he is definitely now. 3 game points for Liang Jingkun here for a 3-1 lead. What can Fan do from here? Well, ekes out the first game point, two services to come. Didn't win the backhand trade there, but that's been the big thing. Fan has just not won a lot of points in that, a key area of his game plan. Liang has been so steady with his backhand. Second game point. Oh, it's good. Liang actually had the first opportunity, chose to go with the reverse. Fan there with his forehands. Third and final game point here.
Timeout.
Oh, timeout called as well by Liang. Of course, remember the coaches are not there. All Chinese affair here. But Liang, it's quite obvious here and perfectly right to do that. He's using his timeout, allowed one timeout each. But he's using the timeout here to try and break Fan's momentum. Because there's no discussion going on here. It's a pure attempt at momentum breaking. And that is perfectly legitimate. Will it work? That's the question. 2 game points have come and gone. Real drama here in the Hung Expo at the moment, with the world number one rocking somewhat at the moment against his fellow Chinese here, Liang Jingkun. Hasn't used the full minute, most of it. Just a chance to towel down and compose himself. And as I say, look to try and break that momentum of Fan that he was looking to build up, saving the first 2 game points. Another service to come here. Will that tactical ploy from Liang
9-10
bear real fruit? 3rd game point here. Once again on the Fan serve. He's got him. He has got him. Real drama here in Budapest. Liang Jingkun, the timeout worked beautifully for the world number 9. He takes the game there, and he's now in the box seat. The world number 1, Fan Zhendong, is rocking here in real trouble.
Fifth game, Fan to serve, level.
Well, we had a big shocker, didn't we, in Wednesday's schedule with the world number two, Xu Xin, going out to Simon Gauzy. Are we about to get another here? The world number one, Fan Zhendong, a game from defeat.
One.
The runner-up 2 years ago in Dusseldorf has won pretty much all the big prizes in the last year to 18 months, has been at the top of the ITTF world rankings for the past year.
Love two.
Clearly, he can still come back from here. But this is a huge hole for him to be in. I mentioned the difference between two games all and 3-1. Although he saved two of those game points, you've got to say, Liang was always ahead in that fourth game as well.
One, two.
And he's fully deserving of this. Nine in the world and 3-1 up in games. He would have signed off for this beforehand, I'm sure. Needing just one of the possible three remaining games here.
Let one, two.
Let service called there. This is an amazing position for him to be in. Let service, so Liang will go again here.
3-1.
Yeah, just need to keep it together at the moment. Maybe just these first few points of this fifth game. Liang's allowed his mind to wander ever so slightly. He is just a game away from what would be a huge upset.
3-2.
Massive forehand. Huge cut taken at the ball there. He's been fearless, but he's been controlled. Fan Zhendong, having lost the early advantage in this fifth game. So both players now having used their timeouts for the match. Well, I wonder what the fans here in Budapest are thinking. We expected, as I say, Liang Jingkun to test Fan Zhendong. This was never likely to be another 4-0 drubbing, not with the way Liang has played over a period of time. And the fact that he beat him on the way to winning that Austrian Open title in Linz at the end of the 2018 ITTF season. But saying all of that, this is still, I think, a surprise in many people's minds at the moment that he's 3-1 up in games. Just not happening at the moment for Fan Zhendong.
Set 4-5.
Oh,
wow. Would you believe it? I mean, that just, there's some disbelief here. Edge of the table, acknowledged by Fan. Is this to be the day? The huge day for Liang Chenkun. He's beaten Fan before, but if he could do it at a world championship. Fan there manages to tough that one out. Again, he wasn't able to win the point initially through his backhand side. Did enough there. Enough angle on the forehand. Redirecting to take that one.
Five, seven.
I mean, I've got to say, I think the feeling here in the Hung Expo is one of disbelief. Just general surprise. The runner-up of 2 years ago. In many people's minds, I know Ma Long is looking good. People are looking at him to possibly defend the title here. But many would have gone for Fan to win this. And he might
six,
still do. Huge serve to come here for Fan.
Seven, ooh.
Did he just play a little bit tentatively there, Liang? Not on the final backhand there, just thought earlier in the rally. Maybe could have done a bit more that time. He's got the services now. 4 points away. It will still feel so far away, though, for Liang. At this stage.
Eight, seven.
There's one of them in the bank. Can't take that, and the service now moves to the world number one. Big, big forehand. Needed that. The length, immaculate. He made just enough space there, Fan. Fire trade. Well, it was six games in the semi-finals in Linz that Liang Chenkun needed. Registered a 4-2 victory over Fan there. It could be that he needs at least six games again here because Fan has the advantage now in this fifth. Takes both his service points. Real grit and determination being shown here by the world number one. Two game points here to take this to a sixth game. And he has taken it. Fan Zhendong with a lifeline there. He wins the fifth game, 11-8. And Liang Chenkun now leads by 3-2.
Thank you.
Sixth game, Liang to serve, Lavo. One love.
Start of the sixth game here of this men's singles round of 16 here in Budapest at these World Championships. And Liang Jingkun, despite losing that fifth game to the world number one Fan Shendong, still needing just one more. That four-game magic total to register the big upset.
Got it! One.
Where he's been so effective, of course, when it's gone into the backhand topspin trades. But his Fan now starting to assert a little bit of supremacy there. That just a bit tight as well. Played so well most of those first five games, Liang. Real emotion, vocalization from Fan this time. See what that meant to him. It's only the third point of the game. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant from Liang. Just muscled this away and managed to angle. So difficult to redirect there. The quality of Fan's topspin. Managed to get it onto his forehand and hook it away ever so slightly. Huge shot.
Three.
Yeah,
two.
Pump of the fist as well. I love the emotion being shown by the pair of them. All Chinese duel, of course, and no coaches there. It's just the best man wins. Being played absolutely in the right spirit.
Got it!
Three, all.
Now Fan hits back. This is a good tussle. He's toughed it out. Has he got him now here, you feel? Liang Jingkun there. He was relentless in his forehand attacks. Scintillating series, searing forehands. And look at Fan try as he might. Very difficult for him that far away from the table to be aggressive. Trying to counter tops, but Liang just too much pace and power. Lead up to three.
Let
now a let
six,
service.
Three.
As I said, in Linz at the Austrian Open, Liang recovering from losing the first game there to run out of 4-2 winner. Is history going to repeat itself here? Oh, he snatches
four,
at that one.
Six.
He's still got work to do here, and he's... It's so much inside the mind at this time. He's playing beautifully. You can't really pick too much fault in his performance in that way, but can he keep it together mentally here? It's the event in Linz, of course, one of the top-tier events on the ITTF World Tour, but these are the World Championships. This is a serious upgrade even from there. Now Fan is coming back again. Deep breaths time for Liang here. Still ahead in this sixth game, but only by one. Oh no! Well, he got lucky with the return of service. And then he just seemed to lose his awareness there, Liang. That's a real let-off for Fan. He did very well, of course, to dig this one up, but you wouldn't have expected that. That could be very costly. Just didn't maybe seem to know what to do with the ball there, Liang. Maybe wasn't expecting it to come back. Couple of services now for the world number nine. Oh, that's cheap from Fan. Missing that reverse return here. Just moving away. Now that win in Linz, it was the first time, sixth meeting between them in their respective careers that Liang had beaten the world number one. This is a whole different kind of performance for Fan Shendong. He's so used to taking a cleaver to opponents, just dusting them up. We're having to try and see a different side to him here because he's been behind playing catch up for a long time and he's behind again here. He just hasn't been able to feel comfortable. Often talked about those backhand cross table, those topspin trades, where he's so dominant, and he hasn't been able to do that here. Oh, and now fortune for Liang, and he's 2 points away. I mean, start to wonder, is it meant to be here? For that to come, I mean, no chance for Fan here. The adjustment, he couldn't make it. Is this meant to be Liang's day? 2 points from victory. Well, again, the disbelief around the Hung Expo here. The favourite in many people's minds for the world title this week in Budapest, the world number one Fan Shendong, is down 3 match points. 11, he's done it. Incredible. Liang Jingkun beats the world number one, the favourite for the title this week in Budapest. In many people's minds, Fan Shendong is out in the round of 16 stage, and you have to say, richly deserved, and the right result. Liang Jingkun has been one of the players of the past year on the ITTF World Tour, but to come and produce this at the World Championships, that level of performance, simply sensational. He's through to the quarterfinal, and Fan is out. Final score then. Fan coming back to win that fifth game, but he couldn't carry it on, and Liang Jingkun through in six, beats Fan just as he did in Linz, 4-2, but this time it's at the World Championship. Amazing upset, even from a top 10 player, beating the world number one. That wasn't expected. Let's hear from Liang now, after that stunning win.
Congratulations on winning this match. How would you describe this match? Because you and Fan Shendong are teammates, you are pretty familiar with each other. 恭喜你取得了胜利，因为你跟樊振东是队友，非常熟悉。这场比赛你如何评价呢？
我觉得我把我自己摆的位置非常低吧，毕竟人家是世界排名第一，然后我要去拼人家，反正在场上我也是一直每分都在咬吧，然后我的心态可能要比他好一些吧。So
for me, Fan Shendong is the top seed number one, so I put myself in a lower position, try to challenge him, and I stuck to the match points by point. So that's my key point to win the match. So this is your second time in this World Championship. How would you feel? 这是你第二次参加世乒赛，感觉怎么样？
我感觉这次有目标吧，第一次可能还小，只是去尝试一下。这次是带着目标来的。So
in my first World Championship, I was still very young and I was trying last time, but this time I have a goal, so I'm trying to reach my goal. Thank you. 谢谢。